Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And man, last week it was crazy. That ending was insane. But we get our first win on the season. It happens to be against Wisconsin, which makes it so much sweeter. But man, I mean, from start to finish, that game was crazy. But we're going up against Bowling Green, so we have the opportunity to have a little win streak going. And if you look at how our schedule is coming up, so we have Bowling Green, then we're against Kansas State at home, which I don't know how good Kansas State really is. They're ranked right now, the 3-1, but I don't know how good they really are. So we're going to get a test at home versus them, but first on the road at Bowling Green. But let's look at how they rank in the nation. So they have a bottom tier offense. I mean, they're 107th in total offense, which is only, 6 yards ahead of us. So not too great, you know what I'm saying? But their defense isn't great as well. I mean, they're ranked in the bottom half of the NCAA. So we might be able to do some things versus them. I just want to show you my recruiting board really quick, and then I want to show you we can just gear up one of our players, because man, a lot of guys balled out last week, so they deserve it. Lewis Parker still our top recruit, but let's look at our commit. We actually got our first commit, which is Josh Dunbar, 69 overall cornerback. If you look at him, 87 speed, he's got 79 excel, which is I don't know, but play recognition at 83, which is something that we've been actually wanting, because none of our guys have good play recognition. But 82 man, 84 zone isn't bad. So I think this guy actually has a great chance of starting year one. Might be one of the freshmen that we have starting year one. But Lewis Parker's at the top. Bo Anderson, we're still 220 yards, 20 points behind the next school, Purdue. Ashton Cohen, who's a 69 overall quarterback, and look at him. I mean, he's pretty good. And he's a JUCO as well, so he might be coming in start next year as well. So he comes in. Ben Miller is a tight end that I actually found a couple weeks ago. We're still way behind on him, but if you look at his stats, 78 overall, 80 catching, 80 route running, 84 speed. And you know, if you have a route runner at tight end, you can do some things. And Cantrell's been playing amazing the last couple games. I'm really proud of what he's been doing. Kellen Oliver is another gem that I found, 76 overall. He's going to be a freshman. So he looks like a receiver, 82 route running, 83 catching traffic, 87 spectac, 83 release. So he's not gonna be the fastest guy, but he's gonna be a guy like that I can put anywhere on the field. I mean, honestly, outside, inside, and he has decent ball carrier skills too. I mean, if he had the speed, I might consider putting him at running back, but he's definitely a receiver since he doesn't have the speed. Chad Ball, that receiver, the JUCO receiver. These guys are all first. So we got these guys all first. Look at this. I'm way ahead in him. Justin Washington, which is a guy I'm excited about. I keep raving about him. Adam Grant, a tackle. The punter. Scott Tyree, a strong safety I just added to the board. He's pretty decent. He's 67 overall. You might be like, damn, he's only 67 overall. But look at his tackling skills. I mean, he has pretty good tackling skills. 68 is tackling, which is the lowest. I know what you're saying, but pursuit at 80. Block shed at 80. I mean, I don't have guys that have 80 block shed or 80 pursuit right now. None of my guys, I don't think, have that high. So Joshua Rich, another quarterback, and Matthew Hines, another quarterback. So this is what our recruiting board is looking like. But let's just get into gearing up the man. I mean, I can't be more excited enough about Ramsauer, but let's look at him. So Quinn Ramsauer, 6'1", 218, number 45. I started out the season with him at right outside linebacker because I wanted to see him get after the passer, because look at his attributes. He's got 85 speed, 88 excel, so I thought he's going to be getting after the passer. After the first couple games, he had maybe one sack, maybe. So I was just like, man, what the heck is up with this guy? So I moved him to middle linebacker, the second middle linebacker next to Wiley. And man, he is just stuffing runs. He's in on every single play. So I'm actually going to gear him up a little bit. He's been asking for a visor. He wants a dark visor because look at his gear. I mean, he has dark bands here and dark sleeves. So I actually like those gloves. Those gloves are kind of icy. But let's just give him that dark visor. And let's go up to it and let's switch his helmet. So I'm actually just gonna give him a new helmet and new visor. So let's see. He's got the Rebel 3 bar. That's kind of ugly on him right now. Let's look at the linebacker. That's all right. I like the three linebacker. Look at the cage, Revolution Robot. Ooh, I like that full cage though. It makes him Ooh, that makes him look icy though. That face mask is huge. He looks like he's about to pop you with that thing. So you know what? Let's put that on him. Let's put on the Nike visor. Let's give him a dark visor. Nobody on our team has a dark visor, so let's give it to Ramsar. Let's make him look mean. I like that. I like that a lot. His shoulder pads are already at 100, so he looks like a monster right now. So I like that, but Ramsar, I'm excited for what he brings to this defense. He's been doing it the last couple weeks. I like it, man. So let's hop into this gameplay. Bowling Green, let's get it. Let's go. Now that we won that last game versus Wisconsin, we finally have an opportunity to start a little win streak. And as you can see, Brad Spencer is starting out this game off with a bang. And that time, it's a 59-yard return to start out the game. So here we go, man. Carrington, who's been pretty good lately. I mean, I can't complain about his quarterback play, getting his tight end Cantrell involved and giving the ball to that man, Jared Ingram, who had a pretty nice game last game. So Ken Carrington, facing a third and down early, does underthrow his receiver. So we do settle for the field goal. And that time, I was actually surprised that my field goal kicker made that. That was from beyond 45 yards. Usually he doesn't make that. But Bowling Green and their offense comes out to the field and finds an open receiver. Morris gets a block, skips into the end zone, and that was easy. I mean, that was so easy. My defense is early in games. I mean, they just don't show up, it seems like. So here we are back on the offense, and look at Carrington stuck in that stupid triple option animation where he gets frozen. So now we're facing a third and long because of that, and we get swallowed up. So the Bowling Green offense takes over, and they've been throwing the ball pretty much all the time, and Morgan is finding his receivers, and this time finding Redding, his outside receiver there, for the nice 12-yard gain. But on a first and 10, attempting to sit in the pocket, but he holds the ball a little too long, and Frederick comes up with the interception. What a great play by the senior safety on that one. And that's going to be the first pick by this Marquette secondary here. So here we go, man. I mean, we got the ball back, but we throw a pick and give the ball right back to them, trying to find McCray as Carrington there. And he starts out this game pretty rough. 1 for 5, 12 yards and an interception. So now we're back on defense, and Morgan picks up where he left off. Besides that interception that he threw, he throws a pinpoint throw this time. And this time he has all day to sit back in the pocket, but this time too much of that pass rush is going to get to him. That time it was Sergio Parrish. So on a third and 12, he's going to have all day to throw. Once again, he's throwing it deep, but Ramsauer is there for the deflection. So we do force the field goal, the long field goal attempt, but that one is not even close. So the Marquette offense takes over, and Carrington needs to make up for that interception on the last drive. So what does he do? Find his tight end Cantrell across the middle. That was kind of a dicey throw, but it fits in there. So the drive continues, and on the next play, Cantrell is going to try to make one of those dramatic plays, one of those great spectacular plays, and he throws another pick. And right away in this game, Carrington is showing that he's human. I mean, he's not just that accurate guy that has no throw power. He's going to try to, you know, use his feet more often, try to throw on the run, but he's making some mistakes early. So this Bowling Green offense, led by Morgan at quarterback, is gonna take advantage, but this time they're not, and Kerry Goss is gonna be there for the interception, and Morgan can't believe it on that one. And this is 4 turnovers by both teams already in the first quarter. We haven't even reached the second quarter yet. All these turnovers. And here we are, a minute left, and what a spin move that time by Stanford. But look at this, a holding call brings it back on a fourth down, so we do have to punt the ball away. But on the punt, the returner cannot hold on to it, so We recover the ball. Look at that. It hit his hand. He tried to scoop it up, but we recovered. So the Marquette Golden Eagles get another turnover. So that's five turnovers combined by these two teams in the first quarter. And we're going to give a heavy dose to Jared Ingram because we know how much Harrington is struggling to be accurate right now. So we just got to feed the beast Ingram, and he gets in for the touchdown. And just like that, man, we take the lead 3 points, and that's going to be the end of the first quarter. So here to start out the second quarter, Morgan's going to bring his offense back out on the field, give the ball to his running back Cleveland. But I mean, the Marquette defense swarms to the ball. So on a 2nd and 9, rolling out to the right, Morgan throws an absolute dime across the field. Look at this. He's throwing, rolling all the way out to the right, throws all the way back across the field, and that one was an absolute dime. So Morgan, he might be finding his groove, because here he's finding his receiver on the sideline, and once again giving it to Cleveland, getting inside the 20-yard line. So couple of plays later, they get to a first and goal situation, and their backup running back Donovan Wilson straight arms two defenders. Neither team can like hold sustainable drives without turning the ball over. We're being so inconsistent. So here is Carrington back out onto the field running the triple option here, and he attempts to pitch the ball, and like I said, nobody is consistent. And we are just making all kinds of mistakes in this game. This is a Bowling Green team who throws the ball a lot, so we wanted to make them make mistakes. But as you can see, Scott Miller gets open on the left side of the field, beating, I believe that time it was Kerry Goss on the outside, and Bowling Green takes the 11-point lead towards the end of this half. So we had to get back to our old ways, giving the ball to Ingram, getting up a 12-yard rush. So now we're at about the 25-yard line, and Ingram puts on a mean move on the defender that time. And here we go. We're getting inside of enemy territory, getting inside the red zone, and Wayne Miller comes up with the touchdown grab. And this time he was actually in for Medley, because Medley actually got hurt early in this game. So Wayne Miller filled in, and once again, we're going for 2 points, and Stanford gets in on the wide receiver triple option. So now it's 3 minutes left in this half. Bowling Green up three, so Morgan's going to drop back to pass, throw across the middle. That's going to be perfectly lobbed past Wiley on that one. So now Bowling Green is inside the 25-yard line, inside of field goal range. But this time he's going to take a sack. Morgan's going to take a sack. That time it's by Ali Christian. So on a 2nd down this time, he's going to take another sack. And that's 2 sacks in a row. So we're getting them out of field goal range. And on 3rd down, one more for the boys. Back in Milwaukee, Dorsey's going to get in for the corner blitz on that one. So we do force a punt, and that went from 3 points to stopping them on defense. So here we go. We got to put some points on the board. And McCray gets open behind the defense, and that's a nice touch pass that time by Carrington, setting his feet, throwing over the top of the defense. But look at what happens. He took a nasty hit on that one. So he is down, and Zach DeLuca, our third string quarterback, has to come in. But right away, we give the ball to Ingram to take some pressure off of Zach DeLuca, and Jared Ingram delivers for the touchdown. So we go into half. We were down by 11. Now we're up 4 at halftime. And Morgan, I mean, they're just going to keep throwing the ball. I mean, that's what they do. So Morgan on the next play, throwing to Ram Sauer over the middle for the interception. And what a great read that one that time by Ram Sauer. And remember, he had that monster game last week. He continues his streak this week, and he's getting into a groove here on defense. So here we are, man, the Marquette offense back onto the field. But we are led by Zach DeLuca, who can't find his receiver that time. He just needs to settle down. This is his first real extended game action, because we found out that Carrington is out for the game. So Zach DeLuca is going to have to finish this one out. But the Bowling Green offense comes back out onto the field, and one long play to Miller gets in for the end zone for the touchdown. So now we're into the middle of the third quarter now. Morgan is going to find Miller once again, getting open across the middle of the field. And Miller's going to have seven receptions for 171 yards up to this point. He is having a career day. And Cleveland for Bowling Green is running the ball, getting inside the 40-yard line. So on a second and four, Morgan's going to attempt this throw one more time. Remember, he had that weird throw early in the game where he was rolling out to the right, threw all the way across his body to the left-hand side. But this time he does get it completed. But we do get in for the sack. This time it's Ali Christian for his second sack. So third and four, Morgan's going to drop back and once again throw to that left side. And this one is going to be caught once again. The left side of our defense, whether it's Noah Carter over there, whether it's Goss over there, we just get abused on the left side. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the play recognition. Our guys are not recognizing plays over there, but it's definitely something we got to address in recruiting. We got to get some guys who can recognize plays, who can play zone coverage on the left side of the field, because we give up way too many big plays on defense. But here we are inside the red zone, but Zach DeLuca takes a big sack, and that one's on a second and 25. So we do face third and long. We don't get enough yards here, so we do kick the field goal on a fourth and 17. So now it's 3 minutes left in this fourth quarter, and Morgan is going to find his favorite target of this game, Miller, who's having a career game and an historic game for Bowling Green. 217 yards on 11 receptions and two touchdowns. He's just finding a way to get open. But on the next play, Hale is going to be there for the interception. And remember, this was a middle linebacker that lost his spot at middle linebacker, and now he's regained it back. And what a big play that was. And here we are, man. We just got to pound the rock, because we have to waste as much time as we can, but at the same time, we do have to get into the end zone. We're down by four, but Jared Ingram finds an open lane inside the five-yard line, and on the next play, he finds some running rooms, getting inside the guard in the center, getting in for the touchdown. So here we are, up three. We got to play some defense here. 2 minutes left in this game, and Morgan is gonna drop back, throw to the right side. That one should have been picked off. Willie Evans, the backup third string middle linebacker, gets in for a play, but he drops the pick. So Morgan on a third down cannot complete the pass, but a fourth down coming. It's all or nothing here, but he finds his open receiver Wyatt on the sideline, so the drive continues. So here they are past the 50-yard line, and Morgan's going to throw to an open receiver that time. That's going to be Guyton on the sideline. But on a third and three, he's sitting in the pocket all day. Ali Christian gets in there, hits him as he throws, but his receiver cannot hold on to that one. So they do kick the long field goal, and this one is barely inside the crossbar, and they give us a minute and a half to drive this field and perhaps win this game and continue a win streak, or start a win streak, that is. But we cannot get away from our identity. We give the ball to Jared Ingram a couple of plays, and he's getting to the 50-yard line, so we're moving the ball pretty well here. But on a third and two, Hall is actually in, but they get the stop, and we're at the 50-yard line, so we have to make a decision. What do? Do we go for it? Do we punt it? And we decide to go for it because we have Ingram, and Zach DeLuca fakes the ball handoff to him, and he's doing so well on the ground that they have to go with him, and here he is. He's just plowing through the defense for the 12-yard gain. So now it's down to 5 seconds left in this game, and with the game on the line, our kicker comes through and we kick the game winner, and Bowling Green collapses. Remember, they had that 11-point lead. We came all the way back, but they threw so many interceptions. And what a game by Ingram. 200 yards rushing. Who would have thought that he would have such an explosion here? And what a game. I mean, crazy turnovers, so many turnovers, and then Carrington gets hurt. So a lot of things happen in this game, but man, no defense. We got to work on our defense, man, because we did force a lot of defense, but we gave up a lot of yards. I mean, so many yards to that Bowling Green offense, who really wasn't that good. They were just airing it out. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. We'll be back for the next episode going up against Kansas State. So let's go.